go to a park now where I spend a lot of time. It's not actually really a park. It's the corner of two streets in Soho, Spring and Thompson. For me, in the last, say, 2-3 years, has been one of my sort of public spaces in New York. So let's go. It's a two, three minute walk from here. A lot of these tables that are here, the ones that are in Washington Square Park, are set up like this for chess, but normally you would bring your own mat or your own board to play on. I started playing chess when I was a kid, actually. And then in the last year, early on in COVID, I started playing again with some friends of mine online. And then of course, when the show came out, everyone was talking about it, everyone was obsessed with chess, and some people started playing as well. I'm sure that chess.com's online subscribership must have shot up tenfold at least. My favorite is to play in person. That's my favorite. Checkmate. All right, let me get back to my books. This is an English poet. 20th century. Frank O'Hara really loved him, and he does write beautifully. He has some fantastic poems. Like Stop the Clocks is one that you might know. That one is in, what's that film? Four Weddings and a Funeral, or one of those English wedding films. I forget what it's called. Let me see. Here it is, Funeral Blues. Listen to this, it's a beautiful poem. Stop all the clocks, cut off the telephone, prevent the dog from barking with a juicy bone, silence the pianos and with muffled drum, bring out the coffin, let the mourners come. Let aeroplanes circle moaning overhead, scribbling on the sky the message, he is dead. Put crepe bows round the white necks of the public doves, and let the traffic policemen wear black cotton gloves. He was my north, my south, my east and west, my working week and my Sunday rest, my noon, my midnight, my talk, my song. I thought that love would last forever. I was wrong. The stars are not wanted now. Put out everyone. Pack up the moon and dismantle the sun. Pour away the ocean and sweep up the wood, for nothing now can ever come to any good. April 1936, that was written. Checkmate. Checkmate. Yeah, but this is where I often come to Kitchen to read and to get things ready, you know. And another one of my favorites has been Dylan Thomas. And he was a Welsh poet. He actually, there's a bar where you can go to, it's in the West Village. And that's where he had his, I think he had 13 whiskeys or 14 whiskeys in a night. And then he died after that. Let me give you this poem from Dylan Thomas, okay? Because it's a beautiful poem. Where once the waters of your face spun to my screws, your dry ghost blows, the dead turns up its eye. Where once the mermen through your ice pushed up their hair, the dry wind steers through salt and root and row. Where once your green knots sank their splice into the tided cord, there goes the green unraveler, his scissors oiled, his knife hung loose, to cut the channels at their source and lay the wet fruits low. Invisible your clocking tides break on the love beds of the weeds, the weed of love's left dry. There, round about your stones, the shades of children go, who, from their voids, cry to the dolphin sea. Dry as a tomb, your colored lids shall not be latched while magic glides, sage on the earth and sky. There shall be corals in your beds, there shall be serpents in your tides, till all our sea faiths die.
Professore, dove sei? Dove sei? Sei a casa? Va bene, prof. Quindi ci vediamo fra un po'. Ok, ciao. So Mario's gonna come, he has to send a few emails, and then he said he's gonna come say hello. It's important to have layers, you know, when you're in New York, because some days it's super hot and humid, some days it cools down, and then there's a breeze, you never know, especially in the spring, you know? Goes from freezing to boiling humidity, you know? So one thing that I started doing recently, which I never thought I'd have to do, is the hair tie. I always used to laugh, you know, my brother puts it in, he has really long hair. And so sometimes now I have to put it in, but I'm still getting used to doing it, you know? Let's see. Because I like having long hair, it's nice.